Aloha. Welcome to our presentation, Faculty Adoption of OER Through Compatibility and Relative Advantage Training. My name's Emily Bradshaw.
And I'm Stephanie Robertson, and we are both adjunct faculty at BYU Hawaii. So we are doing this project here at BYU Hawaii with faculty, and we're looking at OER and faculty adoption. The research around open educational resources, or OER, largely focuses on cost benefits to students and perceptions of OER. This research has laid a foundational level demonstrating that OER is a viable alternative to traditional textbooks. However, even though 91% of faculty members in one multi-institutional study from 2016 reported that faculty are interested in using OER, only 5% actually did. Several studies illuminate the barriers faculty face in moving toward OER, including lack of or mistaken awareness of what OER is, difficulty finding OER, difficulty in finding time to search, and insufficient institutional support. With these barriers in mind, we are asking this question: how do we overcome these barriers through faculty training? And that's with a theory of change. So what is going to create change? From the perspective of Rogers' Diffusion of Innovation from 2003, two of the main factors in tipping the scale from favorable impression to actual adoption depend on two factors, which are relative advantage and compatibility. Relative advantage in this case is the fact that if faculty do not understand what OER is or the wide range of benefits associated with OER, why would they leave the 91% group of traditional textbook adopters? In terms of compatibility, if they understand the relative advantage but do not have the means or support to use OER, favorable perceptions are less likely to translate to adoption. Essentially, we will use the ideas of relative advantage in our training to show the benefits while providing hands-on training to allow faculty to experience how OER can be compatible with their needs.
So what's happening out there? Looking at OER faculty training from a design standpoint is unexplored territory in the research. While researchers have included training programs in the K-12 sector, a gap in the literature exists for design studies of interventions in higher education, especially those that consider both relative advantage and compatibility. But we want to focus on one example, one training program that we feel is a strong training program mentioned in the literature. Kimmins 2016 was involved in 4 3-day workshops with the goal of training K-12 teachers to understand openness in a more expansive way than just focusing on cost savings. Although the specific design of the training was outside the scope of their published research, the training was built around the 5 R's. First, the training focused one day on teaching teachers to retain and evaluate OER. And second day, it gave the teachers an opportunity to revise, reuse, and remix. And the third day, teachers had the opportunity to redistribute their OER by placing it under a Creative Commons license. So this was a great example of training that seeks to overcome barriers to OER adoption at the K-12 level and looking beyond just cost. Certainly, it gave participants a sense of the relative advantage of OER. However, we are proposing a different format because the persistent barriers to OER that Kimmins identified, they're shown on the slide here, are not necessarily the same always for higher education. Also, we want to tailor our intervention to our university in terms of compatibility training. We don't see ourselves as fixing an intervention here. We see ourselves reframing the intervention to promote change at our university. So, while focusing on the two areas of relative advantage and compatibility, we are using the COUP framework to establish our outcomes for the training. This framework was established as a guide to researchers to broaden our focus from cost savings to other important potential positive impacts of OER. But what better way to acquaint our colleagues with the outcomes and impacts we are understanding better through current research than to use the COUP framework? In other words, we will use the COUP framework to backward design our training. So what will this training and study look like? We will get 10 to 15 participants from across various disciplines representing different demographics. The training will take place as a Saturday workshop. And you can see that we organize our training into relative advantage, the relative advantages of cost, outcomes, use of OER, and perceptions, the COUP framework. In each section of training, we will provide information about compatibility resources and training to demonstrate how our faculty will have practical ways to move forward with OER adoption in their individual context. Following our workshop, we'll provide periodic one-on-one mentorship follow-ups.
So let's talk about how we will, tailor this to our university. In the interest of time, we will very briefly detail the basics of our intervention objectives. Students from over 70 different countries come to our campus to get a great education at BYU Hawaii, supported by dedicated faculty and staff. At least half of those students participate in the iWork program, where they are employed part-time at the Polynesian Cultural Center in some capacity, which pays for their tuition, housing, and cafeteria fees, but leaves not much left to pay for textbooks. This is where we use relative advantage and compatibility to discuss cost. We will have statistics from our bookstore about how much students pay for books per discipline. This is a matter of equity for our students. We will challenge our faculty to find low or no cost books and teach them ways to search for OER and databases to use. Everyone will leave this part of our workshop with OER they could potentially use in their classroom. For outcomes, we are particularly interested in how user analytics of OER can help identify places to improve instruction and outcomes, such as using EdTech books. For use, we will show how OER enables greater representation of our international student body. Reusing helps teachers support one another in course design. Remixing helps scaffold language learning and even allows students to repurpose localized OER from their own countries. Through OER, we hope to assist in an internationalization movement across campus, which can still tie in place-based pedagogy, because creating more opportunity for OER-enabled pedagogy is essentially localization for many due to the international student body. In this way, the international can recognize the local and the international is made relevant to the local. For perceptions, we'll present success stories to show the advantages of changing perceptions and allow time for participants to self-reflect on their own perceptions.
We hope that our project will contribute to the research on how intervention changes faculty perceptions. We'll give our participants questionnaires at 3 points during the project: pre-workshop, post-workshop, and post-follow-up. We'll ask questions to gauge changing perceptions about the cost, outcomes, use, and perceptions of OER. For example, we'll ask the participants how cost benefits might impact their students, how the quality of OER impacts course outcomes, how OER can be used in their classrooms, and how their perceptions towards OER adoption have or have not changed.
For follow-up and future directions, once our study is complete, our university is small and close-knit, and we plan to continue to support our participants should they need a colleague to bounce ideas off of, and hope other faculty will show interest in using OER too. Should there be future iterations of the same training, we hope our initial participants can also serve as support to colleagues in their programs as well. Additionally, we hope to partner with our librarians by utilizing our campus LMS, which is Canvas, through their modules for faculty outreach, so we can collaborate across programs to strengthen our campus pedagogical practices and instructional methods. As you can see, our diverse international student body provides a fantastic sample to work with and motivation, our why, if you will. As we approach faculty to be a part of our OER movement we are hoping to initiate through this study, we will support them for the long haul in finding materials to encompass diverse needs, ways of knowing genders, disabilities, ethnicities, orientations, and lived experiences. Please reach out to us at any time if you have questions about this or would like to follow up. There's our email and our references used. Thank you for your participation today. Mahalo.